Hello and welcome to the familycomputerclub.com. Robert wants to solve the problem below. You have been living in the house you bought 10 years ago for $300,000. At that time, you took out a loan for 80% of the house at a fixed rate, 15-year loan at an annual stated rate of 9%. You have just paid off the 120th monthly payment. Interest rates have meanwhile dropped steadily to 6% per year, and you think it is finally time to refinance the remaining balance. But there is a catch. The fee to refinance your loan is $4,000. Should you refinance the remaining balance, how much would you save / lose if you decided to refinance? An interesting problem that I'm having trouble with. My logic has been to find what the payments would be for the original loan and then determine the value of the loan at the end of period 120. This would be then the amount I would want to refinance at the new rate, factoring in the refinance charge as an additional cost. Once I know the two payments, original loan payment and the new refinancing payment, I felt I could discount them back 60 payments to compare any gain or loss from refinancing. This is not working. Any thoughts? Robert, thoughts are pretty good. I have a feeling though that he's not able to execute them. So let's see how we can use Excel to solve this problem. Let's minimize this first. So here we have the cost of the house, and the person has financed 80%. He has taken 80% of the cost of house's loan. The annual rate of interest is 9%. The loan period in years is 15. So we can easily calculate the PMT. All right. The payment per month. Now, how do we get this balance of loan at the end of 120th payment? This is quite easy to calculate, only takes a lot of time, because here we have the monthly payment, which can be broken down into the capital payment and the interest payment. But Excel has a lovely template for this loan amortization. So why not use that? So let me show you how to use that. So we'll open another instance of Excel. We'll go to File, New, and we'll use Templates on my computer. From here, from the spreadsheet solutions, we'll take the loan amortization. We'll say OK. And here we'll fill in the details. Loan amount is 240,000. Annual interest rate is 9%. Loan period in years is 15. Number of payments per year is 12. Start date, let's say it is August 1st, 2012. We make no optional payments here. And if you see now, the loan summary is given here. Oops, there's a zero missing, so we'll put that. And there you see exactly the payment that we calculated. There are 180 payments for 15 years, 12 into 15. This is the total interest, and below is now the interesting thing. So here you have the complete data. It's here the payment date, the beginning balance. This is the scheduled payment. There is no extra payment. This is the payment that you will make, the total payment. It is broken down into principal and interest. So here you have the ending balance. So if you go down now, let's say to the 120th payment, before I go here, just let me go to Tools and unprotect this document so that I can scroll down. So let me go to the 120th payment. So you can see here that this is the balance remaining. Now, this will become the initial payment or the initial loan for the refinancing option, isn't it? All right, so let me minimize this now. And you can see it's very easy to use the template. So we got this result now. For the new loan, this becomes the initial amount, isn't it? The interest rate is 6%. The loan period remaining is 5 years. We can easily calculate the payment per month that we have to make. Now, if I refinance it, I will save per month a difference of these two payments, isn't it? This minus this. All right? And the total payment over a period of 5 years will be $10,030.10. Now, this is what I will pay in the future. So I have to calculate the present value of that future payment. So we go here and calculate the present value using this formula. Quite easy, isn't it? Because we have the 6% value, this per annum, we are paying monthly, so divide by 12. Total number of periods is 60. B13 is the difference that you are going to pay, that you're going to get every month, isn't it? And future value 0, and the type is end of the month or 0 again, and we get this value. So we have converted the future payments to a present value from which we can deduct the refinance fee, and we are left with a saving of 4,646.88 cents, or 88 cents. Now we can round this up. Use the function round up to zero decimals, and there we have our saving. So this question gives us a saving. So we save 4,647. Therefore, we should refinance. I hope you found the solution useful. Thanks for watching.